Hello, calling friends. So today is Sunday, and as usually, we are here together to see results of our weekly challenge, Find and Color. And for last week's, we've got rather rare prompt to find and color sheep. Yes, indeed, it turned out to be not that popular character in coloring books, and many of you wrote me in emails that it was really hard to find a picture, to find that sheep somewhere. But I'm glad, because at the end we've got 40 submitted illustrations, and it's much, much more than I had expected. Same amount as with Caterpillar, but Caterpillar seemed more popular character than sheep. Of course, there are some repeating illustrations from same books, but still there is quite a choice, and there is a lot of really funny sheep, cartoonish style. I think all the illustrations are rather funny. Maybe one, two more realistic, but mostly they're rather funny and cute illustrations. And let me show what I was able to color for this prompt. And the first book is the official Outlander coloring book, and I decided to color this picture that is so, so not me, because it's a landscape and some house. Those who know me for some time, you know that I don't usually color this type of illustrations, but here I decided I would color this one, because this book was still untouched, and the picture itself looked rather boring for me, and so I decided to use a different medium. Not color pencils. Actually, I wanted to use watercolors, but I was scared because there's a lot of smaller details, and I thought it would be hard for me to deal. And so I used instead watercolor pencils. And the paper turned out rather good for this media. I was able to layer several layers of watercolor pencils. And the paper behaved really nice, and I'm really happy with the result. And it was fun, because the picture was rather boring for me, but at least working with watercolor pencils made it more fun, and I kind of enjoyed it really. So I surprised myself. Not typical illustration and not typical material for me. And only for the clouds, I used gouache to cover those black lines. No regular colored pencils, everything with watercolor pencils. And yeah, I'm glad I have started this book finally. And I think the result is rather nice, especially considering that I don't use watercolor pencils that often. After that, I still had some time, and I thought that I would be able to color some another simple illustration for this prompt, and I couldn't help but choose this funny looking sheep by Deborah Mueller, sheep portrait. And again, it was really fun to color this illustration, nothing difficult about it. It was just relaxing coloring and really fun, and I love how the sheep looks. When I started coloring, then I noticed that there are some horns here, and they didn't look like sheep horns, you know, male sheep horns. It looked more like goats, but the look of it's sheep. So I was confused, and at the end I decided to cover those horns and used acrylic for the background, so no horns be seen, just poor sheep. And I'm glad. What else I use here? Markers, then colored pencils, and a lot of white gel pen, of course, and acrylic painter to cover black lines on these green green leaves. So it was easy but fun, and I think it looks cute. So these were my illustrations. Yeah, I also want to say that I had to reject a couple of illustrations, submitted pictures, because on some there were colored llamas, and there was one picture with a little goat. They all was nice and cute looking illustrations, but I thought it would be unfair to include them in our gallery, because after all they are not sheep, and the prompt was to color sheep. So I hope no hard feelings about me rejecting your coloring pictures. I think it would be fair to include only sheep illustrations. And so let's watch our final slideshow of all the sheep, and I hope you will enjoy it. Let's go. Thank you. shows our gallery of last week's prompt, Sheep. And thank you everyone who took their time to find and color an illustration for this prompt. Thank you very much. And now it's time to choose another prompt for the upcoming week. I'm taking my magical box for this, as always. And as always, I'm curious what we'll get this time. Let's find out. Oops. Friends, we've got long hair prompt, so I think this one is rather easy prompt, and you can find a lot of illustrations with characters that have long hair. It's women, girl portraits, as well as guys. There are guys with long hair, and not only portraits, and some story illustrations with some characters and that have long hair. It would not be a problem to find an illustration for this prompt. For any taste, I believe those who like coloring portraits, they can find portraits, and those who don't like, they can find some other illustrations with people or maybe animals with long hair. I too have quite a lot of illustrations, and so I'm off now to search through my coloring books, mostly to choose the most interesting for me illustrations for this prompt. See you later. So I'm back with a bunch of coloring books. And yes, this was a very popular theme, and I didn't have to look through all my coloring books. I was able to find quite enough of illustrations already for this prompt, and again, it will be hard to decide which one to color at the end. I have 4 untouched coloring books where there are suitable illustrations for this prompt, so I think I should use this opportunity to start at least in one of these coloring books and color something. And the first one is Birmingham by Mardell Rubio. Interesting, I do color printed illustrations from his other books, but can't start this one. I don't know why, and for now I have chosen this illustration, very lovely fairy, I believe, with long hair, very cute looking. Then I have this Taru Magic Gate coloring book that I haven't colored anything in yet. There are a few suitable illustrations, but for now I am thinking about this one. What a halo of long hair. Then this coloring book, The Fairy by Anne Kronheimer. Same as with another one of my coloring books that I couldn't start for a long time. Same with this one. For now, I have chosen this double spread. It looks rather a simple one, but again, I have much more illustrations that I like more than this one. Costume Coloring Heaven collection. I'm thinking about this one, a very nice sweet couple, and the girl has long hair. Queens of Poland haven't colored in it for quite some time now, and there's this lady with long hair. And then another illustration, I will show you that not only people you can color for this prompt, like for example this horse, it has long hair, so this picture also will go for this prompt, long-haired horse. Creatures of the Night, Sarah Richter. Ah, this beautiful man with long hair. Deborah colored this guy for a monthly color long for the prompt Handsome Hunks. And I really love this picture too. Would love to color it. And as you can see, he has quite long hair. Then another example from a circus coloring book by Sarah Walsh. This guy, I'm not sure, is it yak or some buffalo? No, no buffalo, it's yak, I think. He has quite long hair. So I think this one will go too. As you can see, llama here, looking very much like a sheep, but with longish neck. But it's llama. And last one, Kirby Rosanna's Mythomorphia. There are a couple of suitable pictures with mermaid and someone else, I believe, but I will show you this this guy. It's not like a human, not a horse. For those who don't like coloring portraits and people, so I think this is something different, mythology theme, but the guy has long hair. So that was my choice, no PDF this time, because I have quite enough to choose from coloring books, for printed coloring books, and it's going to be hard choice what to color at the end. And so that was all for today. I hope you will find something interesting in your collection for this prompt. I'll be waiting for your works. And see you next time. Bye.